There's an ethical dilemma when it comes to parents, students, and teachers regarding social media. In my opinion, it is not ethical or professional for a teacher to be connected with their parents or students online. When teachers open their private lives to parents, they are inviting them to have an opinion on what they say, do, and post. I believe parents and students should only be involved in a teacher's life in a professional manner. Parents that are connected online with their children's teachers don't always know where the line should be drawn. Sometimes parents think that their child should get special treatment because they are friends online. When teachers are only connected with some of their students' parents on social media, it can create a problem among the other parents. This can cause issues because other parents say the teacher is playing favoritism or even being biased towards those students. If a teacher is friends with a parent prior to the student being placed in their class, they still should not be connected on social media until after the student goes to the next grade. A teacher may post a funny comment on Facebook in a joking manner, but a parent could see it and take it the wrong way. Something as simple as a teacher tagging another teacher in a funny post about maybe how crazy the job makes them could be offensive to some parents. They could think this is how the teacher really feels about their job and their students, when in fact it was just a funny joke that we wanted to use to relieve some stress about the job. Also, if a teacher goes out with friends or family and has some drinks and posts pictures, all of their connected parents will see those photos. If more than likely is an innocent night out, but that's not how every parent's going to view it. Either way, the teacher is showing a side of their lives that should be kept private. Teachers should display a professional appearance to parents at all times, and that is not always possible with social media. Another instance where it can be a problem is if a teacher makes a political comment online and a parent sees it. Politics is a very touchy subject and has been known to divide friends and family. A parent can be very upset about a teacher's political views. While teachers have every right to their opinions and to what they say and what they post on their own personal sites, when they are connected with parents, it can create a problem, and it is just not worth it. Students and teachers connecting on social media in the elementary level is not as common as the students are younger. It is more common for middle and high school students to try to connect with their teachers. Since the students are minors, this is inappropriate. No matter how you look at it, teachers and students should not be connected in their private lives. There have been many cases reported against teachers for inappropriate conduct and relationships with students that all started online. To eliminate this issue, it is best for teachers to not accept any contact through students online other than a school-assigned email. Some teachers argue that they use social media to connect with all of their parents quickly and easily. If this is the case, they can just as easily use their school email. Another option is to create a personal classroom website like Weebly that parents can join. This will eliminate the need to use a personal social media account to keep in contact with parents. The websites can be used strictly for relaying information about the classroom. There are even websites that require a password before accessing so that it will protect the privacy of the students. Some teachers like to use social media, like Facebook, because a lot of parents are already on that site and they know that they use it regularly. It is possible for teachers to create a classroom Facebook page or group that is set to private that parents can join, although it would probably be a good idea for them to turn off the private messaging in this case. With any of these options, it would be also best to set boundaries. Teachers should also invite their administrators to join the site so they can contribute to the website or see what's going on in their classrooms. Student privacy is something to keep in mind if a teacher decides to open a classroom Facebook group or website. The teachers should get signatures from parents allowing their pictures and names to be mentioned and displayed online. Not every parent is okay with their child's identity being posted online. Even if the district has a form that parents sign, teachers should create one specifically giving them permission for their websites. The beginning of a new school year is the best time to set boundaries and draw lines with parents regarding social media. If a teacher would like to use an online site to connect with parents, it should be communicated with the parents and running as soon as the school year starts. If this is done at the start of the year, parents will know that the teacher plans to actually use the website and keep it updated. Many times I have seen teachers create a website only to stop using it after a month or so, and parents stop checking. This defeats the purpose of using social media to connect with parents. This is also the time that they can let parents know that they do not add parents to their personal social media accounts. They can inform the parents without seeming cold or unfriendly. They can suggest that they continue connect through the classroom sites, and if they need to contact the teacher directly, they can always use their school email or phone. Teachers should also ensure that their personal accounts are private. There are many situations and issues to take into consideration when teachers and parents connect online. The best way to avoid any unnecessary problems is to not accept requests from parents. I believe teachers should keep their private lives separate from their personal lives.